You don't have a title yet. But at the end, you might give him a title. Men have a huge responsibility as men. Having to build a home. From responsibilities of taking a wife. Even before they take a wife, he has to have enough for the future, for the prospective wife and children. A man does not live for himself, he lives for the other. Any child will always say, when dad is around, everything is possible, everything is fine, everything is all right, and nothing can go wrong. The child needs no harm can come to him when the dad is dead. The dad is the God he or she sees on earth. Men, before they get a job, the kind of ups and downs they go through is so much. The society does not expect men to show their feelings. They must bottle up every feeling, pain or agony. Just act like everything is fine. So that a man becomes his only friend and coach. This is really unfair because before God created man and woman equal, and there is no distinction in a man or a woman or in their souls. Men should show their feelings. They can't even tell their wives, kids, or family what they pass through. It is really unfair. Typically, when a man loses someone very dear to him, the society frowns at a man showing emotion. Anyone who usually say, be a man, as though men are not human beings. A man seen crying is perceived as a weak man, a weakling. God himself made crying a mechanism or a natural way of calming oneself. Men are not allowed this privilege to cry to calm down. It could be very harmful if men are made to bottle up and never express their feelings. We keep saying it is a man's world. However, how is this a man's world? In difficult situations, in war times, men are sent as soldiers. In crisis and rescue missions, men are sent and expected to face whatever danger they encounter as men on foot. In a crime situation, men are usually the first suspects. A lady's accusation will usually earn her more credit, even without proof. Men are actually deprived the right to be human. They are seen as superhuman, which they are not. Every major responsibility in the house is up to the man, the father, to fix. In fact, he has to be a magician in all situations. Women do not really care about the process. And we usually say, he will get it done. Female kids are brought to their fathers because they are very sensitive to their daughter's needs and understand them in the wild experience of puberty. As they grow. Due to the way men mask their feelings and emotions, women are perceived to be more in need of care than men because the society and situation have over time formed man to mask emotions. Therefore, the mothers seem to get a better attention for their children than the men. Even when the men may need it most. Men have a can-do attitude. Everything is fine. You can't have a man say, I am not fine, even when he's dying. A woman is allowed to break down, but it's not acceptable for a man to break down. A man should not be seen breaking down, saying he is tired, he is feeling pain. The progression of high blood pressure to stroke stage is more frequent in men than in women. This is not surprising, given everything we have spoken about. The family does not pay enough attention to the father, largely because of the way a man will usually mask his emotion of pain. It will be noticed that when illness strikes a man, it is almost at the terminal stage where little or nothing can be done that it is noticed. As a woman, you should be a monitoring spirit, at least in a positive way, to your husband and sons. Because they usually will not tell you what they are passing through and their pain. The society will not even permit them to do so. Therefore, men can hide and take their medication. If men will learn to cry, if the society will let men cry and stop frowning at men crying, if men will be allowed to tell how they feel, a lot of detrimental effects will be salvaged. Women should be friends to their husbands and sons. Sisters should be friends to their brothers. Girlfriends should be friends to their boyfriends. Yes, men are breadwinners, certainly. But breadwinners are flesh and blood too. Men should also learn to open up and get help when they need it. I dedicate this piece to all men out there, those struggling to stand on their feet, those trying to start up families, those who have started families, those that are jobless and having family responsibilities, those that are dead and never reaped the fruits of their labor, those that died in war fraught out of patriotism or in defense of women, those that are widowers, the priests who in most cases are seen as mega superhuman and have no children and families of their own. To all men who are not appreciated for all the struggles they go through, to men who are abandoned by their children and their wives and the people they have all through their lives worked to save. Prayer. I pray for all men around the world that the struggles you go through in life will not conquer you. Instead, that you may conquer life and reap the fruits of your labor. St. Joseph the Worker, pray for us.